Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel and welcome to all you newbies. I really appreciate all of you. So today's reading is for the Divine Feminine. If you're male watching this, you can still watch this video because we've all got feminine and masculine energy in. But I'm being drawn to do a Divine Feminine reading today because, I don't know, I'm getting the vibe that Divine Feminines are a bit low at the moment. So take what resonates, leave what doesn't. This is a general reading. I think I've covered everything. Yeah, and things are energies as well, so we'll go from there. Right, let's get started. So your cards I already drew before I started the video. You've got message of guidance here. So with this card here, Spirit is saying, Divine Feminine, you're not listening to the signals that they're giving you. So it could be that you're blocked off, your intuition's closed off at the moment. It could be maybe you're going through something at the moment and you're not listening to the signals that they're sending you. And you doubt yourself quite a lot as well. So with Source, which coincides with that guidance card there, this is your spirit guides trying to guide you, you know, trying to show you the way. And, you know, Spirit understands you're feeling out of sorts at the moment. I think this is why I was drawn to do a Divine Feminine reading. Like I said, I'm just picking up you lot are feeling not all there at the moment. You know, things may not be going quite right in your life at the moment. With this card as well, it's like Spirit is saying you don't feel fulfilled. You feel quite disappointed in a lot of things. It could be people, it could be a situation, it could be work. And Spirit's saying you doubt your spiritual abilities as well. It's like you know, why have you got this block here? And Spirit says that with you question everything. It's like if you're given a sign by your spirit guides or by the universe, you will question it and then you will doubt it and then you will just like disregard it. So Spirit wants you to maybe try and do some meditation, you know, connect with your crown chakra, because your energy is blocked at the moment. You're not receiving the messages from Source, okay? And be careful the way you think and the way you speak, because it's law of attraction, isn't it? When we put out things into the universe, we get it back, don't we? So Spirit wants you to be careful with the way you think, be careful with the way you speak, because if you're constantly negative, like negative Nelly, you're going to attract that, okay? Spirit is saying you've got abundance that's coming to you. You know, if you could just maybe be a bit more positive, whatever's going on, which we're going to look at, you've got abundance coming towards you here. You know, abundance and happiness, I mean, what more do you want really? And I think if you can actually get past this block here, this is what's in store for you in the future, is abundance and happiness. And I feel like mainly it might be just you're happier with yourself. But we'll look at the situation because I am picking up that there's something going on with you lovely people. So, let's have a look. So, tell us more about the Divine Feminine Spirit. How is the Divine Feminine feeling? What is going on with them? What's going on? Oh my God. Looks like there's a lot going on with you guys. So I'm going to take those two. Yeah, look at this, guys. Look at this. You have exactly what these two cards said straight away, is that you're all up in your head here. You are thinking negatively. You're your own worst enemy here. You're constantly thinking negatively, and it's like you're trapped in this cycle. It's like you can't get out of it. I feel like you've got a lot going on with you at the moment, and maybe you don't know how to get out of it. Maybe you're feeling depressed because this is a depressed card, and you know maybe you don't see a light at the end of the tunnel, okay? But Spirit is saying here, look, we've got the Star, Aquarius energy here. You can manifest your dreams. if you want the abundance and you want the happiness here, you know, you can receive that if you start thinking positively, if you start putting out into the universe, you know, positivity, basically. And the star could be, it could be that maybe you've started a venture here, maybe you've gone into business on your own. It could be, I mean, with this, I'm picking up more of some online, like you could have a platform, you could, you know, have started something like that, and it may not be going too well. But with the star energy, this is being in the spotlight. It could even be that for some of you, take what resonates, okay? It could be that you are actually in the spotlight, but this has brought you nothing but misery. You know, because people online, you know what they're like, most of them. Well, not most of them. I take that back. That's wrong of me. You get that odd one or two that cannot be happy for anyone, that they have to be nasty in the comments and things like that. And touch wood, I've not had that yet. All I got the other day. All I got the other day was they couldn't understand me. And I thought, I know my accent could be quite cockney sometimes, but I was like, oh, okay. I'll try and talk a bit more clearly. But anyway, so yeah, it could be that that's depressing you at the moment. But, you know, you've got the power to be happy. You know, follow your dreams. You know, this is the wish card as well. If it's something that you've been really wanting and you've been craving, it's there for you to take. You just got to change your mindset, okay? And then on the back of the deck, the energy, overall energy, is the Four of Cups. You feel discontent. You feel bored. It could be that you feel rejected. It could be maybe like, maybe you're not getting the offers that you thought you were going to get if you were starting something new here. And you're just getting rejection after rejection after rejection, you know what I mean? So, and that's made you feel really low. It's actually not your confidence, Divine Feminine. That's what I'm picking up. It's not your confidence. Let me look at the Eight of Swords. Tell me about the Eight of Swords. Oh, I just want to fly out today. King of Swords, Three of Cups, Eight of Wands. Three of Cups is a friendship group. It's going out and having fun. It's get-togethers, it could be anniversaries, weddings, you know, all that kind of thing, celebrations. But it also could be an invitation. Now, I'm going more the invitation here by the King of Swords, air sign again. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, got very strong air sign here. You've received some kind of communication or communications coming towards you, but I feel like you've already got this communication, and this King of Swords wants to speak to you. They want to take you out. They want to, you know, maybe over dinner or a glass of wine or something like that. And they want to communicate with you. But you're all up in your head. Why are you up in your head? Let's have a look. Oh, hang on, guys. It's annoying me. Right, where were we? So we've got the King's. No. So we've got that. Let's have a look. What is, tell me about the King of Swords and the Three of Cups, Page of Wands. Tell me more about the Three of Cups and the Page of, geez, gold. Definitely something going on with you guys. And they've come out like that, but I'm going to take them like that. Okay. Just bear with me. Okay, I'm seeing a totally different scenario here now that the tarot cards are out for you guys. So yes, it could be that you've started something new and you want to watch it grow, blah, 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 blah. But something has happened with the King of Swords with you guys, Divine Feminine, okay? You've put a lot of hard work into a relationship with this King of Swords. Now, I feel like you either recently celebrated an anniversary or like a milestone or something like that, okay? Or it could be that you were hoping for a serious commitment, you know, like more solid commitment, which is marriage. And you were hoping for this. And, you know, but what I'm seeing here with the Page of Wands, it was something that was revealed to you quite quickly. It was so quick, and that's like with the Eight of Wands here. It happened so swiftly that you didn't see it coming. Now, you got quite excited about this. You thought that you were finally going to get this victory with the King of Swords. You thought it was going to, you know, things were going to go your way, and you were feeling really good about it, okay? You're deeply in love with this person because we've got the Two of Cups. You see them as your soulmate here. And you are really committed to this connection with the King of Swords. But what's happened is it came to an end. You were left out in the cold. Who was the one to leave? I feel like it was this King of Swords that left you, Divine Feminine. I feel like they walked away from you. They rejected you. And what you're really upset about here, guys, is that you put a lot of work into this connection. You put a lot of energy, a lot of time, a lot of love. So tell me about this, the world. Tell me about the world. And the thing is, what the King of Swords does, they're really standing their ground on this. They're not budging. They're not wanting to change their mind. And I feel like this King of Swords actually took you out to actually tell you that it was done. And I feel, I don't know why that just came into my head. For some of you, you thought you were going to get the proposal, the victory, the love, the commitment that you were really hoping for, and everything was just shattered. And, you know, we've got a depressed card here, we've got a depressed card here. So your mental health is really suffering at the moment, Divine Feminines, okay? So this is why you're in the mindset of everything is going wrong. It could have even been with those two cards at the beginning. What Spirit is saying is that you were being shown these signs, what was coming, what was right in front of your face, you know, what you wasn't seeing, and your spirit guides were showing you, but you just wasn't seeing it because you're closed off to your intuition and your psychic abilities and things like that. You literally was asleep. And it could be that, you know, this King of Swords energy here could have been, I mean, the King of Swords can be quite narcissistic, you know, and controlling. And it could have been one of these energies here that done a lot of gaslighting, made you out to be crazy, you know, and then you just started believing it, okay? Page of Swords, Queen of Cups, the Hangman. you're still waiting for some kind of communication or for this King of Swords to come back and change their mind, because we're clarifying the world here. Now you're waiting for this King of Swords to change their mind, to communicate with you, but what Spirit is saying is the news is actually delayed at the moment with the Page of Swords. And I feel like there's a lot of gossip going on about your connection here. There's a lot of rumours going on. And it's making you, you know, try and find out. You're trying to dig to find out what went wrong or what's going on, you know, with the King of Swords. I feel like you're doing a lot of digging at the moment. You know, because you are the Queen of Cups. The Queen of Cups, here we go, guys. She is an empath. She is psychic. But your abilities got, you know, they're sleeping at the moment. And there's you sitting here in love. You know, you've got this big cup of love that you want to give to this King of Swords. And you're sitting there and you're waiting for this King of Swords to come forward. And the Hangman, it's all about enlightenment, you know. It's all about facing the truth. It's all about feeling stuck. You know, it speaks about being at a standstill as well, guys. Things are literally just at a standstill. It's not moving. You know, Seven of Pentacles, this is saying that this is not going to go anywhere. It's like no effort. There's no effort on this King of Swords side here. Tell me about this King of Swords. Wow. Seven of Pentacles in reverse. They don't want to put the effort in, guys. They don't actually want to make an effort. The Fool. New beginnings. I feel like they just want to go off and start somewhere else. So let's get some advice for you guys, okay? What advice would you give the collective spirit? What advice would you give them? They're very sad. Two of Pentacles. What advice would you give the collective? Divine Feminines. What do they need to know? Wow, it's unusual. Ten of Cups. Tell us about the Ten of Cups. The Sun. The King of Cups. You got a pair here. Okay. I know you're hurting, Divine Feminine, because because the King of Swords obviously left you, and I know it's heartbreaking when that happens, but what Spirit's advice to you is once you've healed, because at the moment you're out of sync, you're not quiet. Steady at the moment. Your emotions are literally all over the place. You know, one minute you're up, one minute you're in a good mood, then you're not in a good mood. So you're all like this at the moment, which is understandable. And once you get yourself, you know, into a better place, you've got this commitment that's coming towards you here. Okay, you've got the King of Cups. This is someone totally different to the King of Swords. The King of Swords was someone that is actually quite cold, didn't really show their emotions. They weren't very loving, you know, they're very detached when it comes to emotions and things like that. So with the King of Cups, he's the total opposite of what you're used to. The King of Cups is someone that is emotionally available, very compassionate as well and sympathetic, and they're very charming. And they've got all this love to give you. And, you know, this is your equal here, you know. That's your counterpart, that is. So you've got this Ten of Cups here. This is, you know, this is happiness. This is joy. This is children. It's marriage in your future. It's everything that you wanted with the King of Swords is going to happen with the King of Cups here. And, you know, this is going to bring you pure joy and happiness. And I feel like it's something that you never experienced before with, you know, the King. I think you're going to actually realise the difference between the King of Cups and the King of Swords, that you're going to look back and think to yourself, God, I wasted my time with that arsehole. So, yeah. So let's get some oracle here for a bit more advice for you guys. So yeah, it's the King of Swords did reject you with the Four of Cups. That was the overall energy. It was rejection. I mean, it could be for some of you, you know, you could have been just casually seeing this person and you wanted more, you know, because feelings were involved here for you, Divine Feminine. You were in love with this person, whereas their feelings, it wasn't mutual at all. So we've got blessed sight. See, look here. Hopefully, if you'll listen to your spirit guides and the universe and the signs and everything, you're going to be able to use the sight that was given to you. Because like I said, you guys are psychic as well. You're empaths. And hopefully in the future, you will see the red flags and you will see the signs. And, you know, then you'll be able to deal with it. Because I'm picking up here, Divine Feminines here, you guys are actually very spiritual as well. We've got creativity. So that could be what I was saying at the beginning about something you wanted to, something that you started may not be going the way you thought it was going to go, but Spirit is saying keep creating, keep doing what you're doing, you know, it's going to pay off. You've got happiness and abundance coming towards you. Abundance because it's something that you've started here and maybe you've just not been into it because you're depressed at the moment because of what's happened with the King of Swords. But you have happiness and abundance here. Then you've got prosperity. Look at this. Guys, you've got so much good stuff coming to you. You have. And then you've got divine love. There you go. So there's your counterpart. Like I said, the King of Cups is your counterpart here. I mean, you could even maybe meet this King of Cups in the summer because the Sun card is summertime. So wherever you are in the world when it's summer, that could be where you meet them. Picking up, we could even meet them at the park. At the park or by the sea. Yeah, but you've got the King of Cups coming towards you. I like that. So I'm going to leave it there, guys. I hope this resonated for you and you have a wonderful day or evening wherever you are. And I'll see you soon. Bye.